Hey, good morning, Dirt Time followers. I want to welcome you back where I'm going to introduce to you a 309 CR with high flow. We are here at the Peterson Cap facility in Medford, and we are under the shade for a good reason today. It was up over 116 degrees the other day. So some of the features and benefits we're going to talk about today. This is a 20,000 pound machine, give or take. It's got a C 3.3B. with about 70 horsepower, a little bit more, a little bit less, depending on how you've got it set up. It's got all-day comfort, stick steer, travel mode, cruise control. It's got a swing boom on it, pattern changer in the monitor now. It's got a dedicated auxiliary pump, 37 gallons a minute for all your work tools, especially for the 208 mulcher and the 210 flail mower, which you're going to see a video of the flail mower a little later on. It's got a quick coupler on it. All these machines, the 309s, come standard with thumb ready. And now we're going to go back to our director, Josh Franklin, where he's going to show you a video of our work tool specialist, Kirk Carter. Thanks for joining in.
Hello, I'm Kirk Carter with Peterson Cat. I'm the work tool specialist here. And today we'd like to talk about the HMF 210 flail mower. So some of the features of this is it's got a 40-inch working width. It takes hydraulic flow per the two on the front. It's hydraulic flow of 18 to 34 gallons a minute. Its max cutting diameter is 2 to 3 inches. We also have an HMF 110 with a 40-inch working width. Only takes 13 to 21 gallons a minute. Max cut on it is still 2 to 3 inches. Some of the features on the flail mowers is the chain guard protector keeps the debris from flying out. Integrated rear roller that you can see right there. That helps keep the teeth from going in the ground. Keeps it level. Balanced drum, bolt-on staggered teeth, swinging teeth. It's got the Cat XT3 hose, and it's got the integrated stand. So when you take it off, it actually will stay in a place where you can hook back up to it. And then we also have the Cat mulchers, pretty similar. They're both 200 series though, 208 and 210. The 208's got a 32-inch working width. The 210's got a 40-inch working width. The hydraulic flow both are as two. They are high flow, 18 to 34 GPMs. Fixed teeth per drum. We've got 15 on the 208, 18 on the 210. Max cutting diameter on this one is 5 to 8, much heavier and a different kind of cutting. Some of the features on the mulcher are the dual hydraulic doors, so you can decide how much debris you want going out or how much you want keeping in there. Balanced drum again, integrated stand, and the XT3 hose, of course. Some of the other attachments that are available for the 309 are the, we got augers, Cat augers, Cat compaction wheels, couplers, you can see it here, a hydraulic coupler, flail mowers we just talked about, hammers, mulchers we just talked about, scrap shears, thumbs, vibratory plate compactor, and tilt rotator systems. If you have any questions on these, please feel free to give us a call at Peterson Cat, and you can call me at 541-554-8814. And also, we will be showing a demonstration of this later on in this video, and you'll get to see it actually in action. Thank you.
I really want you to get a picture of that, because that. Welcome back, Dirt Time followers. Ronnie LaClair, host of Dirt Time. Where we're going to introduce to you the 309 CR High Flow. We're going to do a walk around on the machine here, come around to the back. Behind door number one, we got our CEM, our clean emissions modules here. We have right in here, Daniel, is the main pump. And then this is our brand new dedicated auxiliary pump for work tools. We also have our coolant, engine coolant shunt tank right there. As we move around the back, Rear camera mounted right here, great. You can turn it on full time inside the cab. Here you have your engine oil check, engine oil fill. Actually, that was our window washer reservoir over there. This is our coolant shunt tank right here. My apologies. We come around over here to this side. We have our air filter right in here, cooling packages right here, battery compartment, and some of our relays inside here. Now in behind this door, we have our diesel water filter in here, separator filter. And then if you look in here real close, Daniel, you'll see these two red handles. This one here is when we put a one-way flow attachment on there, we need to put it in one-way flow, like our flail mowers. And then also if we're running the flail mower or mulchers, we want to go to high flow. One of those attachments on, you're doing both. If you just have a hammer on, you're just going to do the back one for your one-way flow. Down here we have our master switch. Now you notice there's no yellow light because it's on this machine. Let's come around to the front, Daniel. Our hydraulic tank is the outer tank right here. It holds 14 gallons. The whole hydraulic system holds right around 26 gallons. Right next to it is our fuel tank. So our hydraulic tank, we check it here. We open this hatch here to fill it. Fuel tank, we have gauge inside. We have a wake up mode now. We can check our fuel levels, but this is where you actually add it. On top of the fuel cap is a filter. That means that's an open loop system there, Daniel. We come around to the front. We have our blade here. Standard blade is 94 inches wide, so right at, or 97 inches wide, right at 8 feet. And then you can get a wide one, which is 104 inches, which is about 8.5 feet. As we talk about, we have our stick and boom. We have a dig height of 15.25 feet and a dig depth of about right around 13.5 feet in the standard mode setup. If you go to the long stick, it's going to add about a foot more to the dig height and 2 foot more to the dig depth. We have the thumb ready. This one actually has the thumb package on it. Quick coupler right here. This is going to be 10-hour service points here. The blade is a 50-hour service. As you come around here, Daniel, we have a 24-inch bucket on here from our work tool specialist. Quick coupler, you can see it down in there a little bit closer. We have second auxiliary 2 and auxiliary 1. When you guys hook up the flail mower or mulchers, you're going to hook up into here and make sure you're going to turn this little valve on each side to dedicate the flow to those attachments. As we come back around here, you can see the swing boom. I have it set up so you can clearly see the swing mode the machine is in. As we come around here to the side where we started, in behind here is our outside air to inside air cap filter. Right in here, Daniel, tucked in tight is our inside air cap filter right here. Just pull the tab down, pull this out of the way, and then you have access to that filter right in behind there. Comes out fairly easy. All right, we also have on this control right here, the yellow button is your stick steer mode. You push that, you accept it on the dash, and you can set excavator mode or blade mode. If you accept blade mode, it turns this joystick into your blade control. If you select excavator mode, you still have your excavator, your boom and stick out here. And I say stick because you put it into stick steer mode. You pull this trigger, now you can use this to operate your stick. On the other side, if we're in excavator mode, is your actual blade control over there. Hydraulic lockout right here. Cool thing here, Daniel, if you can get a shot at the monitor, right down here we have a wake-up switch. You just push this button and then it wakes up the monitor there, and it will show you what the hours are and what your fuel level is, so you don't have to jump up in here and turn the key on and wait for the monitor to fire up. It's a really cool feature I like. Cruise control is also on this joystick here. You go into your monitor, you turn cruise control on, you start moving your machine, go to stick steer mode, start moving your machine forward or reverse, whatever speed you want. You'll see that in a video later on today when I was running the flail mower. I put in cruise control with stick steer, and I was able to walk along and run the flail mower. So to activate that, turn it on the monitor, and then you pull this trigger right here when you get the speed you want, and then the rest is all onto the machine. Standard features in the cab is the cruise control, the stick steer, the wake up mode, the rear window, emergency exit. There's a little hammer right up inside there. You can bust that window out to get out. We also have a next gen monitor with a jog dial over here off to the right hand side of the operator, easy access. It's got a cup holder, also a cell phone holder in there, hard hat holder up on the back up there. It has an air suspension heated seat. It's a really cool feature, but not this time of the year. The air suspension is good. Pattern controller inside the machine now. We don't have to go out here and dig around until we find a valve to switch from backhoe loader controls to SAE/CAT controls. I think that's about all I have now, so I'm going to send it back to our director, Josh Franklin, and he's going to run a video of some of the things that we did with the machine yesterday with the bucket and with the flail mower. Thanks for joining in, and I hope you enjoy these videos. Welcome back, Dirt Time followers. Ronnie LaClair, host of Dirt Time here. Just want to remind everyone to hit us up with some questions. So go ahead and start typing in those questions, get them sent out to us, so we can come up with some answers for you. A couple of things I want to talk about. The swing boom on here, it swings 60 degrees to the left, 50 to the right. And when you're working this thing, that's actually quite a bit. That's a great job. You can actually get up in there close to the back of the machine when you're in swing mode, right up close to the tracks there if you need to. Another thing I wanted to talk about, the cab noise inside the cab with the doors and the windows shut, about 72 dBAs. When you're standing outside the machine, it's about 99 dBAs on that. Also, this machine is equipped with an advanced monitor, which means we have main pull and cross slope integrated into the monitor so you can see where your machine sets there. So again, we're here at the Peterson facility in Medford. It's a great morning. We're right next to Biddle Road here. The parts department, the service department, and rental department are all back over here behind me. So hit us up with some questions so we can get back to you.
Does anybody else offer fixed air control on this size excavator?
So the question is does anybody else offer cruise control on this size excavator? And the answer is no. Got any other questions out there?
We got a dedicated pump for work tools. What's the deal?
Yes, we got a dedicated pump for work tools. So the 309 is pretty much a 308, beefed up a little bit. And they actually, the main pump comes right off the back of the engine there, and then they stacked another pump dedicated for work tools. So what that does is I can operate the machine. I can move it forward, move it backwards, blade up, down, boom, stick, all that stuff, and still have all the power to my work tool. And anybody that runs those flail mowers and those mulchers know it takes a lot to get those things to run. And like on a 308, it's a really good machine, man. Everybody likes that. I liked it. But you were really limited to what you can do. So with that dedicated pump at 37 gallons a minute, and your work tool out there is about 31 max with the high flow setup on here, it does the job with no problem at all. It's really great to run. I enjoy it.
I got a question. You were out working a long time in the heat yesterday. How was it?
So on Monday, the temperature was up around 116, 117 degrees. When I opened the cab, it was pretty warm in there. I fired it up, and within 5 minutes, the AC had that cab cooled off, and I was out there running that machine, and I never, ever got warm in there. So the AC, HVAC unit on these machines are really great now. They had, they actually had several opening vents that you could point right at you and at the windows and help keep that cab really cool.
Does it come equipped with a quick coupler? And can you operate the bucket in shovel mode?
Yes, you can operate. So the question is does it come with a quick coupler? That is, you have to order that. That's extra. That is not standard. Am I right, Ben? So that the quick coupler is not standard. And the other question was in shovel mode. Yes, you can. You can turn this bucket around and operate it in shovel mode, which me being a mainline guy, it comes in really, really handy when you're doing that. I'm sorry? To drop the bucket, turn it around, spin it back on, depending on the operator's experience, but anywhere from 20 seconds to a minute and a half. There you go. Yeah, I won't be in that. So, doesn't take long to drop off your work tool and attach up. If you're dropping off a bucket and then hooking up a mulcher or a flail mower, it's going to take a little while longer simply because you've got to hook up three lines, two pressure lines and one case drain. And the machine runs, I don't think I mentioned it yet, but both pumps, the main pump and the auxiliary dedicated pump, run give or take a few. About 4,100 PSI on that machine. It's a lot of flow. Any other questions? All right, cool. So I want to thank our director, Josh Franklin, and our Caterpillar industry expert, Ben Rice, came out here today. Boy, was I relieved to see him. And of course, I'm Ronnie LaClair, our work tool specialist, Kirk Carter. I just want to mention that SciTech, our SciTech friends, this is a really, really busy time of the year for them. There are quite a few SciTech options that you could put on this machine. And next time we get a chance, I'll get the SciTech out here and we'll talk a little bit more about that.
Hey, can you mention the Think Big program?
Oh, the Think Big program. Josh Franklin, he's going to come out here and talk a little bit about the Think Big program. Nope. So, Think Big program, we get some young people in here. They'll get an education at school, and then they'll come in and work part-time in the shops. I'm not really sure. Is it 6 months on, Go to petersoncat.com, Think Big program there. I'm a little too old to get in it myself, so I apologize for that. So until next time, appreciate you all tuning in. Have a great day and stay cool. Thank you very much.